this was something that came to my attention one night when I was reading through the Virginia Code. I found out that the state that graciously allowed us to do this should we so desire. And in doing my research, it didn't appear that anybody around us has done it. But we have a much higher people tax than the surrounding counties. My interest is in staying competitive with the surrounding counties when it comes to attracting new businesses and encouraging businesses to relocate to the city. This is one tool that we can use to do just that. All it does is prevent a new relocating business to the city for a period no more than 2 years of the B-poll tax. In speaking with the Department of Community and Economic Development as well as the mayor, they have both voiced their support for this paper with one amendment, which was an oversight on my part in the first report. And that was in section 2, the very last sentence, be changed so that it has an effective date as of July 1st, 2013. This will give them the time to get anything together that they need to do as far as being aware that new businesses or relocated businesses are coming. And it also helps as we prepare for the budget season to understand exactly whether or not this will have any added benefit to us in terms of real estate sales tax, admissions tax, meals tax, etc. So it comes with the support not only of myself, but also of the administration and the mayor specifically. I ask that you all vote for approval for the council. I will let you know that if this amendment will require that the amendment to continue at the next meeting until the February 11th meeting. At the next council meeting, I'll be introducing a resolution to create a task force, and I believe it's going to be co-patient with the mayor, to develop a group that will make recommendations for changes to the way we do the B-poll tax with a more willing start date of July 2014, maybe July 2015, depending on how difficult it is to craft this in a way that ensures we are being good stewards of taxpayer money, but also attractive to new businesses.
Thank you. Are there any questions of Mr. Sanders?
Looking at the last 2 years, we identified just under $100,000 each year saying is, looking back at the last 2 years, the initial additional payment from new businesses was just under $100,000 a year. But on top of that would be the ability we have to go back 3 years hence, go back to that initial year and raise that assessment. And I don't have those numbers.
I think it's a great proposal. A couple of thoughts that stick in my mind, though. Are there any base requirements to qualify other than just being a business in the city of Richmond? Do there need to be a certain capital investment or a number of employees that these people who will bring your business here next?
State law doesn't provide for us to put any additional requirements on it. The federal state, you gotta go with what the state tells us, so we just follow the state.
Okay. And then following that line of reason,
downtown.
miss out on the opportunity for us to acknowledge the city and the Economic Development Office and all of the other departments of the city that are involved in the process of building permits and inspections and marketing and, you know, incentives and the work that your office is doing, the work that many of the offices of the city is doing, that makes it possible that that we could receive a report as we did the other day from Mitchell Richmond of what your work and what the city is actually doing to make this a reality. So I think we need to take advantage of an opportunity to expand on that and give the city an opportunity to be a part of tuning out homes as well as recognizing what has really been done. So one of the things that I would like to know a little bit more as it relates to this specific paper, though, is we say we're not competitive. I'm interested in knowing in what ways we are not competitive with people tax. What's the difference in our rate versus our surrounding counties? What's the difference in the total volume of their revenue that comes in because of that versus ours, or whoever we're comparing ourselves to is saying we might be able to just have some sense of whether or not this paper is as far reaching as it needs to be to address, we're not going to cover it, just get rid of all of our non-competitive edges in the process, but it would be good to just have some numbers to give us a real sense of appreciation for how we're not competitive.
As far as volume, I don't know if it's good, but I know that Mr. Lester has some ratings comparison with me right now to show you really the difference that competitiveness.
The B-poll rates are paid, or the taxes paid on per $100 of receipts. And for instance, the city of Richmond had five major categories: professional, personal services, contractor, retail, and wholesale. The city of Richmond is starts at 58 cents per hundred. That's on professional, law firms, accounting firms, etc. And the lowest we have is 19 cents, which is on a contractor. By comparison, Henrico is 20 cents on every category except contractor, which is 15 cents. Chesterfield, 20 cents is their highest, and their lowest is contractor, 14 cents. But to give you an example, if you've got a law firm, an attorney, with $1 million in gross receipts annually, in the city of Richmond, they'll pay $5,800 in taxes. In Henrico, they'll pay $2,000. And in Chesterfield, they'll pay $1,600. That's compared to our
5,800. Good. Thank you, President. Some questions? All right, this time I'm on the public hearing. Anyone who wishes to speak in opposition to this? In favor? Back to the committee?
Can I just?
Yeah.
I will be introducing a paper that's going to, like I said before, that will address the many people tax for current businesses as well. It's just that's going to take a little longer, and I didn't want to hold this paper up. So we are looking out for the local current businesses as well as attractive things.
Thank you.
Jonathan?
Yes. This paper is for new businesses that are coming. But are you also saying that there is another paper that you have introduced for current businesses?
It's not going to address people in a rate way. It's going to create a task force to make recommendations on how to do that.
But just hearing what Mr. Lasker said is a good time.
Amen.
This paper is not, you said there was going to be an amendment.
The amendment, it's on page 7 of your package. Let's see if that's right. Page 5 of your package. The amendment is on page 8, which is page 4 of the actual ordinance. And it's the very last sentence. It currently reads, this ordinance shall be in
in force in effect upon adoption. That's going to change to read, this ordinance shall be in force and effect as of July 1st, 2013.
All right, any other discussions? All right, it's community's pleasure. And I have a turn. You guys can do it for me. Is there a second?
Second.
Get the number. You guys have to get. Come on, all in favor? Aye.
Aye.
Close. Thank you.
Thank you.
Okay, Madam Chair, just to make sure we're clear, that page will go forward with the recommendation to approve with the amendment.
Yes.
Will the amendment continue?
It will be amended and continued on January 28th, is the deal. On the next council Monday, and then I hope that it will be passed by council on February 11th, which is the first council meeting.
Did I talk about that?
Yes.
Okay. Let's go to paper number four.
Item number four, ordinance number 2013-6.
Thank you.